Those who knows them better, they say, Gwaza mkhonto gwaza. Gwaza mkhonto gwaza. Hey, it is those who knows them better. Well, you might probably ask, Bongs, now wavela usuthi gwaza mkhonto gwaza. What's gwazaring here? Well, let me tell you what is gwazaring. Basically, it has been revealed. I saw this from two articles, right? It has been revealed that MK Party has nominated former judge, Ujudge John Hlophe, for JSC MPs to decide this afternoon. So I'll tell you the outcome. Shortly after being sworn in last Tuesday, Hlophe indicated he will accept a nomination to the JSE judicial if his party wants to deploy him there. Here, mind you, you get chased away by Uzondo, Chief Justice Zondo. He removes you into the judicial. The next thing, you sit in a position where decisions about judicials are made. Ay, what a chess game. Maybe you don't understand this. What a chess game, right? Can I repeat this one? You get chased away, right, from your position from a position of serving as a judge. Now you are sitting in a position where decisions about judges and everything that has got to do with judicials is made, which is in parliament. Hey, what an interesting one. Now, if you are the enemy, I'm wondering, how do you feel now that the man you chased away is sitting in a position of power, right? Because decisions are made in parliament, laws are made in parliament, implemented in court. Did I say that very clear? Let me repeat this. Decisions are made in parliament and laws are made in parliament and implemented in court. Right. So yeah, let's go through this. I'll keep you posted if MK Party comes out with if they come back and say, yeah, indeed, the man has been appointed to this. But yeah, we need to break it down. Uguti, what is the meaning of JSGOC? Yeah, so we need to break it down as well. So in an article that was released today, the 2nd of July, at about 10 o'clock a.m. by Andisiwe Makinana. Yes, Andisiwe Makinana, a political correspondent for Times Life. They broke down the story. So I'm going to have to give you, or I will have to break it down for you to understand why and what's the excitement about this. But before we do so, yay, guys, I'm sitting here and I'm thinking to myself, why are you not doing this? If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people. Because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying? Will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. So in that article, it is written, the MK Party has nominated impeached former judge president of the Western Cape, John Hlophe, as one of the MPs on the National Assembly should consider for serving in the Judicial Service Commission, JSC, over the next 5 years. Did I say that? Let me repeat this one. MK Party has nominated impeached former judge, president of the Western Cape, John Hlophe, as one of the National Assembly should consider for serving in the Judicial Service Commission, JSC, over the next 5 years. So you can write a story here and say, from impeachment to overseeing processes in parliament about judges. It's going to be one of the greatest thing to have write about, right? In February, Tlope was impeached by the assembly for gross misconduct, becoming the first judge to be impeached by parliament. He has PhD in law. So that's why I said it's going to be interesting. He gets impeached by this same process, and then the 2 years or what, not even a year later, he's now sitting where the decisions were made to impeach him. That's why I said, if you're looking at this from a historical point of view, you can't help but get impressed by this, and you'll be like, But Parliament papers published on Tuesday shows the MK Party has nominated Tlope to be among the six names the House will consider for the JSC on Tuesday afternoon. Shortly after being sworn last Tuesday, Tlope indicated he will accept the nomination to the JSC if the party wants to deploy him there. So I'm wondering, Guti, the decision for that department, does it lie on the parliament to make the decision, or it lies on the party to say, give us a person to serve in this department, and then the party provides local? Because when you say nominated, to me it sounds like somebody is yet to make a decision whether or not this person is fit for that or not. You know, that final decision, to me it sounds like that. But yeah, let's proceed. He told Times Live at the time, we haven't met and it will be premature of me to make that suggestion. I have the expertise. I have been a judge in this country for 29 years, so I know the system and in and out. But if there are people who are sustainably qualified or are willing to go, they will be deployed. For me, I don't know. Do we have anybody within the MK Party that is as qualified as Tlope as far as this faculty is concerned? I doubt. So since I doubt, then give it to Tlope. Right. He said, there were other committees he was interested in serving in, including the Justice Portfolio Committee and others in the Justice and Security Cluster. Anything before the House for decision is subject to a vote. MP may object to the names amend them or reject them. Oh, if that's the case. But who? Is it the MK or the people in the House? But if they do so, they need to give us someone as qualified as him. Because if they object to that, then give us someone as qualified as him. EFF leader Julius Malema and the DA Grani Bakhambeck, who has previously served in the body, have been nominated by their respective parties. While the DA has proposed newcomers to the national legislature in Molapi, Soviet Holokhane, and Fasha Khasa, Fasiha Haisan, Action SA nominated veteran MP and parliamentary leader Atol Trollip. To serve, this is something interesting, right? To serve in the Magistrate Commission, former Communications Minister Faith Mohambi has been nominated by the ANC, Andrian Roos by the DA, Sibonelo Nomvalo by the MK and Opile by the EFF, right? Cedric is sought to retain. Let's leave this one. So for me, I'm interested in the MK Party's strategy to deploy this man. Well, so, you know, I have those questions to say, what's your take? Do you disagree or you agree? For me, if they reject his name, really you need to prove to me that you need to prove to me that the people you are appointing really have the expertise over and above, over and above this man, if that's not the case, then why not give Hlophe